हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. दिस इज योर सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ इंग्लिश फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल विच इज सिचुएटेड इन गोलाबचर गोरखपुर. माय डियर स्टूडेंट, इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैड ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द स्टोरी दैट इज गिवन चैप्टर नंबर 7 डाउन द वॉल्केनो एंड इट्स वर्ड मीनिंग एंड एक्सरसाइज. सो टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द नेक्स्ट रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 7. सो without wasting the time, let's start the today's video. So student, this is the chapter number 7 and the title of this chapter is Down the Volcano. We have already learned the story of this chapter. So let's revise the word meaning and question answer of this given chapter and also its exercises. Okay student, so here's the first we will learn about the word meaning. So here's the first word is craters, and the meaning of craters is the large often deep holes that form the mouth of volcanoes. Now the next word is bottomless pit, the meaning of bottomless pit, very deep hole. Third is chimney, and the meaning of chimney is crater. Fourth is projection, and the meaning of projection is pieces of rocks sticking out. Fifth is constellation, little bear, and the meaning of constellation little bear, a group of 7 stars in the sky which together are said to look like a small bear. Okay student, now after this there is a next exercise, exercise A. In exercise A, read the sentences and answer the question. So student, there is a first sentence is, but what about the clothing and this great pile of ropes and ladders, who will take them? So here is the first question is question number A, that is who asked this question and to whom. So the answer will be Axel asked this question to his uncle Professor Leidenbrock. Now the next question is question number B, what was being discussed just before the speaker's question. So the answer will be who will carry which type of luggage was being discussed just before the speaker's question. Question number C, how did the listener respond to the speaker's question? So the answer will be, the listener responded to without hesitating that there is no need to carry the clothing and that great pile of ropes and ladders. Now the next question, question number D. In question number D, what happened to the clothing and the pile of ropes and ladders? So the answer will be, on the command of Professor Leidenbrock, hands tied the unbreakable, student here is a correction, you have to write only singly, unbreakable objects into a single packet which was tied solidly together, and then he simply dropped it down into the west hall. Student, the answer of question number D is, on the command of Professor Leidenbrock, hands tied the unbreakable objects into a single packet which was tied solidly together, and then he simply dropped it down into the waste hole. Okay, now the next sentence is sentence number 2, that is, I can just see a curving tunnel towards the right, we will have a look tomorrow. So the first question is question number A, who spoke this word? Whose question was the speaker answering? Who spoke these words? Whose question was the speaker answering? So the answer will be, Axel spoke this word. Axel's question was the speaker answering. Axel spoke these words. Axel's question was the speaker answering. Okay. Now the next question, question number B, that is, where were they at this time? The question is, where were they at this time? So the answer will be, they were at the bottom of the chimney at this time. They were at the bottom of the chimney at this time. Question number C, what did they decide to do after this conversation? What did they decide to do after this conversation? So the answer will be, they decided to eat and then sleep after this conversation. Okay students, so the answer will be, they decide to eat and then sleep after this conversation. Next question is question number D, that is, what did Axel see when he later lay down to sleep? So the answer will be, after laying down to sleep, Axel saw a star which was not twinkling at all. It was the star beater of the constellation Little Bear. Okay, student? After completing word meaning and exercise E, we moving to the next exercise, that is exercise B. Dear student, it is very important for you that you must be revised the word meaning and exercises of this chapter in your PC copy. If you not completed your fair, so you also write down in your fair copy. Okay, student? So let's moving to the next question, that is exercise B. In exercise B, answer this question. Okay, we will give the answer of given question. So first question is, that is given, what happened to Axel when he looked into the crater before the descent began? Student, the first question is, what happened to Axel when he looked into the crater before the descent began? So the answer will be of question number one. Axel became very nervous. He felt his head spinning and he was about to fall. Okay. Now the next question number two. Next question is question number two. How did Professor Lidenbrock solve the problem they were facing with the rope? Okay. The question is, how did Professor Lidenbrock solve the problem they were facing with the rope? So the answer will be, he unrolled a rope 4 feet long and dropped half of it the middle of it to a round block of lava and threw the rest of it down into the chimney. So that's good. Climb down. Okay. He unrolled a rope 4 feet long and dropped half of it the middle of it to a round block of lava and threw the rest of it down into the chimney so that could climb down. Okay, student. Now the next question. Question number three is, how did Professor Lidenbrock divided the things they were going to carry down with them? The question number three, how did Professor Lidenbrock divided the things they Lidenbrock divided the things they were going to carry down with them. So the answer will be, Professor Lidenbrock took breakable object, Hans carried the tools and third of the food, Axel took another third of the food and firearms. Okay, they divided the things. Firstly, Professor Lidenbrock took breakable objects, Hans carried the tools and third of the food, and Axel took another third of the food and firearms. Okay, student? Come to the next question. Next question is question number four. Half of way down the pit, what did Axel see when he looked up towards the mouth of the crater? What reason did he give for this? Question is, half of way down the pit, what did Axel see when he looked up towards the mouth of the crater? What reason did he give for this? So the answer will be, when Axel looked up towards the mouth of the crater, Axel saw the mouth of the chimney which was getting quite a lot smaller. When Axel looked up towards the mouth of the crater, Axel saw the mouth of the chimney which was getting quite a lot smaller. Okay. Now the next question, question number five. In question number five, the question is, how did Axel calculate that it was 11 o'clock when they were about to reach the bottom of the crater? Question is, how did the Axel calculate that it was 11 o'clock when they were about to reach the bottom of the crater? So the answer will be, Axel calculated it with the help of rope, which they folded many times and calculated the time of rest period. After calculating all, they realized that it was 11 o'clock when they were about to reach the bottom of the crater. Okay. Answer of question number 5, Axel calculated it with the help of rope, which they folded many times and calculated the time of the rest period. After calculating all, they realized that it was 11 o'clock when they were about to reach the bottom of the crater. Okay, students? So just like this, you have to revise this all exercises. Firstly, you have to revise voice meaning. After this, you will revise the exercise A. Now the next exercise B, that is a question answer. These all are very important for your examination. Okay, so you must be revise this all and keep it in your mind. Student, after completing exercises of A and B, we're moving to the next exercise that is given. That is make complete words. Words from these words and suffix, you can look up the new word. Dictionary to check it if its spelling is correct. Okay, students, so you have to complete this given exercise. Okay, so there is a first, analyze plus sys. So it will be analysis. Okay, the correct spelling of analysis is analysis. You must be check this given spelling of this word in dictionary. Okay, analysis, analysis. Second is cautious. The meaning of the spelling of cautious is cautious. After this, third is biological, that is biological, biological. Next is happiness. The spelling of happiness is happiness, 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 happiness. Now fifth is activity. So the spelling of activity, activity, activity. Now the next number six is tension. The spelling of tension is tension, tension, tension. Seventh is bravery. The spelling of bravery, the correct spelling of bravery is bravery, bravery. Next is, the last one is organization. And the correct spelling of organization, organization, organization. Okay, students, so just like this, you have to complete this given exercise. You have to check the given spelling of these words. Okay, students, one more time, we're going to recheck the spelling. The first spelling of analysis. So the spelling of analysis is analysis, cautious, cautious, cautious. Third is biological, biological, biological. Next is happiness, happiness, happiness. Next is activity, activity, activity. Tension, tension, tension. Next is bravery, bravery, bravery. After that, after this, last one is organization, organization, organization. Okay, students, so just like this, you have to check the given spelling of these words in dictionary. So dear student, I hope is that clear to you that how could you complete this given exercise in your PC and notebook, in your fair copy also. Okay, so you must be revise this all given word meaning, exercise A, B and exercise D also, that is very important. Okay, student, so just like this, you have to complete this given exercises one by one. You have to revise it all. Okay, student, so that's it for today. I hope it's clear to you. So you must be keep practice of this all exercises at your home, and you have to keep this all in your mind. Okay, student, so that's it for today. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.